Day by day they practice meditation. Day by day they read the Buddha name. So now, they feel peaceful in the prison. They think prison like a pure land for them. They think if they get out of prison, they have to find a place to live. They have to earn the money for food, for clothes, for insurance. So they feel very disturbed. But right now, they feel big in the prison. So according to their mind, they thought no need to leave the prison. They stay there, they practice, but they feel at the lotus temple as a pure land with them. Có nghĩa là sư thỉnh thoảng đi thăm vài nhà tù, người tù. Lúc đầu mấy người đó là tranh đấu đó, đi nhờ tòa, nhờ luật sư để cho họ được ra tù sớm. Nhưng mà rồi sau này họ tu tập thường xuyên rồi, họ hiểu đạo thường xuyên rồi, thì họ nghĩ rằng là không cần phải ra tù sớm. Vì lý do họ nghĩ nếu mà họ ra sớm thì họ có nhiều cái thử thách quá. Thứ nhất là bị gia đình buông bỏ. Thứ hai, họ phải tranh đấu để kiếm tiền, đi trực kiếm thức ăn, rồi kiếm quần áo, rồi kiếm nhà ở. Vô số những cái thử thách. Cho nên đối với họ bây giờ nhà tù nó không phải là tù nữa, mà nhà tù là giống như là Lotus Temple đây, là nơi lý tưởng cho họ tu tập. Hai con đâu? So, like that you understand the pure land. If you read the Buddha name at your home, if you feel you peaceful, your home peaceful, so definitely when you pass away, you will be born in the pure land. If right now you don't feel peaceful, right now you feel suffering in your heart, in your area, you will be born in the negative mind. So what? So, according to him, outside doesn't matter. Even outside lack condition, even outside no money, even outside no enough food, but we still happy. We still practice. We still positive mind. So like that, your life become a pure land. Definitely, when you pass away, you will be born in the pure land with him. You got that? Ha, rồi ha. Rồi ai ý kiến gì nữa? Tiếng cơ đó ý hiểu không? So, yeah.
Hi.
Quay trở.
When you meditate at time, let's say you confuse the two Buddha.
How can recognize different? Rồi thì tánh nói cho cổ nghe. What different between the figure, about the figure? What different between Sakyamuni Buddha and Amitabha Buddha? Cổ hỏi. Con cầm micro lên, cầm micro nói.
How do you recognize the difference?
Chú nói đi.
When you meditate that time, who, let's say you confuse the two, who you call for?
Oh.
So, how do you recognize which one is which one?
Thì là mình có bị...
Confused. Thế thì thiện tánh nói cho cổ hai Phật khác nhau, cái gì mình nói trước về hình tướng ấy. Camilo nói.
You mean you want to have a picture of one Buddha with you?
I mean, I since you explained this way, all the time I think Buddha, is, when I meditate, is thinking about Buddha. But I didn't know that there's a two distinguished.
They are similar.
Let me explain according to what I understand. So of course Sakyamuni Buddha, he's teaching. He has so many ways. The way he teach this person may not be suitable for another person. He always know. Okay, this person, what he need to teach, right? So he can be better. And the person, he different way, different technique, right? The same technique. So that person can be better. A person who's always forgetful, and he said, okay, and do just like this, right? Then he will be.
floor.
You see the floor, for example. And because there's no way for that person to read the thousand sutras, right? So, so just concentrate on thing. And you see the thing we have outside near the bell.
Yeah.
You know, so that's the most simple thing to avoid doing evil, to do, get accumulated, build up the mind. So that kind of summarizes, you know, the main thing, right? So instead of you read thousand, we all you have to do is like that, okay? So anyway, so there's like 1,000 years ago, so people, okay, because the different people, right, they want to practice, you know, his teaching, but because, okay, this way is not suitable for me, and that way is better for me. So they create like a dozen of school, and but you know, some school, you know, because it's so complicated, they can the people cannot practice that. So now we end up with three way to practice the Buddha teaching: the meditation, the mantra, the just recite the mantra like most of the Tibetan monk, and then the Pure Land school. So now in this world, there's just three ways, you know. So it's just simplified. And even the meditation, right, you will see different way, right?
Yeah.
The most simple way that Reverend Yanai has, just to follow your breath, right? And the other way to, you know, there's so many ways.
Chanting,
you know. But chanting is one of the ways that can feel that.
Mantra,
yeah.
Okay, yeah.
So you don't. You will not be confused. So the Pure Land of the way we chant the name Amitabha Buddha, so that we can be reborn in the Pure Land. And but of course that is just to recite the name, it's just one way. And but there's other way to be born in the Pure Land. And the meditation of course, according to what you practice, you achieve a different level, right? That's the today you can sit 5 minutes, tomorrow 10 minutes a day. So you achieve different level, you cannot say it's just one way, right? So you achieve different spiritual level, you know,
yeah,
to what you practice.
And you know, like in the hospital, thousands of patients, thousands, billion, trillion of sickness. The Buddha Sakyamuni, he also see human being, thousand, billion, trillion of people, each one different sickness, different suffering, different level, different capacity, different habit, different like that. So he teach about 8,400 methods for people practice. So usually who the beginner in the temple, in the, so they just learn first, learn general many method. After that, you or they will choose which one suitable for us. Example, today you feel enjoy, you feel very happy when you read the Buddha name, when you walk in meditation, so you follow that. And all the people they come, oh, I like to chanting mantra. I lazy to chant, I lazy to speak up, I want to keep silent, so they can follow meditation. So that different way. You must learn to know which one suitable with you. Like you go to a restaurant, the menu, lot of food. With rice, with the chili, ricey, no ricey, bland rice, you can eat first on. After that, you think your stomach suitable with food, you chew that forever. Okay, that way the Sakyamuni, he taught 8,400 ways. Yesterday we just, and today we just introduce for you few important few methods important and popular people are on practice. And the second thing, I want to show you how to recognize the figure between Sakyamuni and Amitabha. You can tell me about the figure, about the set, what are different. The same, you come pointing and the requiring Bodhisattva, different in lotus and round of tree. So what different between the Buddha?
The position of the hand, one is standing, one is sitting.
Yeah, correctly. Amitabha, he always make right hand like that. What is the meaning? You think that is what is the meaning? Meaning?
Wow.
No, that means welcome and keep hand for people go. That means people run down the sand. You are here? He welcome you, take you go to the building. That is the meaning. Saving.
Saving.
He save you. If you make you faith to him, you conduct to him, virtue at him, read the Buddha name, keep my pure, when you pass away, they are welcome, receive you to them. The same reception is received up in the hotel like that. And Sakyamuni Buddha, his method about precept, meditation and wisdom, so that's why he meditates. So you easy to recognize him. What and what is the name of this Buddha? You know him?
Dhammo.
The Earth Store Bodhisattva, tức là Địa Tạng. What the meaning? He keep the stick. Stick. When we hit the bell, he hit the he touch the earth. People on the hell. They heard the bell, the awakened bell. They heard his awakened remind, read the Buddha name for the Buddha, save them, deliver them from the suffering. Underground, is it? So, his name. We have another Buddha name we call Medicine Buddha. Medicine Buddha. So, you easily recognize he always keep one steel bar in his hand. We call medicine fork in his hand. So you will recognize he is medicine for that. Okay? So now you know in his altar, now Earthstone, Bodhisattva, Sakyamuni Buddha, Amitabha, Kuan-yin Bodhisattva, the Great Wheel Bodhisattva. Oh, today you learn most, okay? Three of them belong to Pure Land. Okay? Right. Okay, now time we end. Any question? If not, so we finish our Dhamma talk today. Also finish our retreat to yesterday and today. Okay? Mình hồi hướng ha.
To have met you in such a way on a bus. first time I see you, I smile at you, and you smile back too. And I say, oh, there's two high priests here. And lucky to meet you, and surprisingly, we're on the same bus. And I saw that you advised the couple woman about taking two seats as one seat. I know your feeling about her not doing the right thing and trying to correct her. But I know why she do that. She's very, very insecure. And she wants everything big, big, big. So she took two places for one. But I know, we I still talk to her. But, and on the way, we talk a lot about Buddhism, and I learned a lot from you. And when, surprisingly, I'm led to this place. Beautiful. Yeah, it's beautiful. It's the best place I ever seen. Oh, thank you. Your time, best place here. Yeah, very peaceful. And yeah, you can practice meditation here anytime. And this 2 days I learned more about Buddhism. I mean, I learned a lot already, but there's still so much to learn. And thank you for your singing. It's so wonderful.
For honor,
the generosity.
Yeah, the honor, the honor, the founder of this temple and his wife cooking there.
Yeah, and open up for everybody.
Yeah.
And we have company too. And I appreciate all this. Thank you so much.
Rồi Thiện Tánh cũng nói vài lời, rồi cô Huệ Nguyên Hạnh cũng nói vài lời nha. Phiêu linh của mình tu trong hai ngày này, rồi xin nói vài lời.
First of all, thank you for being here with us, and of course, you know, we always want to have more friends, right? And I would like to introduce a little bit the history of this place. So for a long time, our Buddhists, when we want to have a retreat, we have to rent places elsewhere, from the cafeteria of the school, the hall of some government center, and the hall of some church. And so we have to rent that, of course we have to pay, and then we have to bring our statue, Buddha statue, bring the seat and the cushion, bring the art, everything with us. And for 1 day, 2 days, we take it there, and we have to take it back. So it is very, of course, inconvenient. And so after many years doing that, my wife, we dream, okay, we need to have our own place. So it's always in our mind. And of course, we have to look, we look at a lot of places, the private residence, you know, the warehouse, and even the raw land. But those places are not suitable until I saw the ad of this church put on sale. And so that is the story. So now we have a place that we want. Of course, our dream is always to have a place so we have everyone, we come here to practice. Not the church, the Pure Land Buddhism, whatever you believe. So you hear it. Because this place, probably we have at the end of the road, and there's no traffic go through here, and it's on the hill, so we have fresh air here around, and then we far away from other houses. So this place we call it is almost ideal to for people who want their peace of mind. And of course, you don't have to practice the way we practice. No? You can practice the meditation, whatever you like, but it's just to offer you a place that you can practice.
Thank you.
Còn cũng xin chị anh đi sư và sư cô Minh Tiến đã tới đây để hướng dẫn chúng con, mặc dù là cũng không có nhiều Phật tử khác, nhưng như vậy cũng có cái hay của nó.
Đúng vậy.
Là thầy cho mình không có dịp gọi là gần hơn,
yeah.
Thì cũng là những chuyện khác mà nhiều không đông người không thể nào làm được.
Dạ.
Nhưng con chưa ông mà đến và các chúng ta sẽ tập được các chiên đi sư và có biên kiến và cũng như tất cả các bạn đã tới đây trước đây hôm nay và ngày về sau. Hãy đi thật vậy.
Rồi cô Nguyên Hạnh nói vài lời, nói tiếng Anh là nói tiếng Việt luôn. Nói tiếng Việt, tiếng Anh giỏi, nói tiếng Pháp luôn cũng đó.
Con kính chào cô, kính chào đi sư.
Nói lớn lớn cho cô nghe.
Con kính chào đi sư, kính chào cô. Ly rất là vui mừng để hôm nay có dịp để tu tập được cô về, được ni sư và cô mời về đây để hướng dẫn chúng con tu bước rất là mới như là tam bộ nhất bái, rồi có những cái câu hỏi trong những dịp pháp đàn con cũng hiểu thêm được nhiều điều mà con chưa thực sự là hiểu rõ. Nhân đây con cũng xin cảm ơn anh chị Thiện Toán và Diệu Âm cũng đã cho chúng em nơi chốn rất là thanh tịnh để mà tu tập. Con cũng đã chuẩn bị có dịp để mà cúng dường sư cô, ni cô, ni sư cho con xin lời chúc cúng dường ni cô, ni sư cô tới đại sư. Và đây là con gửi cô vị cô kim tím tận giúp con để gửi cái sách đây chút này để
cái phương tiện công nhận đi con, con gửi sách cho cổ
rồi mô phật nào
cổ
thiếu
học á.
Con cùng con xin lời gửi lời cảm ơn ni sư và cô và
rồi cho sư cũng là gửi lời nói lời cảm ơn luôn nha. Rồi A Di Đà Phật, ni sư là người nói cuối cùng. Cảm ơn cái đạo tràng này rất là nhiều. Sư biết rằng là nhiều chùa đó mà không có cảnh quan giống như vậy đó, là quý ngài lâu lâu phải đi thuê trên núi, thuê những cái nơi nghỉ dưỡng trên núi đó để có cảnh quan đẹp giống như là chỗ đây. Rồi Phật tử phải cùng nhau bỏ tiền để thuê xe lên trên đó tu học để có cảnh quan đó. Mà bây giờ cái cảnh quan đây á, đạo hữu đạo hữu Thiện Tánh và đạo hữu Diệu Âm đã tạo cái cơ ngơi và trang nghiêm ngày mỗi ngày càng đẹp. Cách đây 3 tháng chúng ta đến thì chưa có cái cổng của Nhật và cái dòng suối thiền. Và bây giờ chúng ta lại có cái cổng của Nhật và có dòng suối thiền. Cho nên ngày mỗi ngày nơi đây thật là trang nghiêm và thanh tịnh. Sư rất là tiếc rằng là chưa được nhiều người biết đến để hưởng được cái sự tu tập tại cái không khí này. Cho nên cảm ơn sự rộng rãi, cảm ơn tấm lòng của đạo hữu Thiện Tánh và Diệu Âm rất là nhiều. Cầu nguyện nơi này được nhiều người biết đến. Cầu nguyện nơi này càng ngày càng đông để sự lợi lạc tâm linh tất cả mọi người rộng mở. Như nãy sư nói, sư tin rằng là nếu chúng ta ngồi đây tụng kinh, nếu chúng ta ngồi đây hành thiền, nếu chúng ta ngồi đây lại tam bộ nhất bái, hình như nó có cái từ trường mạnh lắm, có cái lực mạnh lắm. Cho nên mong cái lợi lạc này được nhiều người hưởng đến một thời uổng ha. Hôm khóa tu 2 ngày của chúng ta vừa qua rất là lợi ích. Trước tiên lợi nhất là sư với Vương cảm thấy sư rất là an lạc, giống như 2 ngày chưa biết lên cảnh Cực Lạc, cảnh trời như thế nào, mà 2 ngày này sư cảm thấy sư thấm đẳm một phần rồi đấy. Cho nên rằng là mong tất cả quý vị tu tập duy trì giữ để chia sẻ cái niềm an lạc này cho khắp mọi nơi. Càng được an lạc thì càng bớt đau khổ nha. Tri ân tấm lòng từng quỷ Phật tử. Miss Lee, thank you very much for your coming. You are lucky to meet us and join our retreat today. Today we are special for you. Okay, because we are all talking Dharma, talking English with you. And we are recognize you are very friendly. You are very devoted. She told me you willing to share labor with us. Yeah, very harmony, harmony. We very welcome you. Even tomorrow I'm back to my temple. But he will keep in talk with you. Any day you have free time, can call him, email him, and come here to learn Buddhism, okay? May the Buddha bless all of you peaceful, and we will see again in next time. Bye bye. If you have chance, come to California. Welcome to my temple. Welcome, become a nun in my temple too. I feed you. The temple will feed you for all life, okay? You will be peaceful, only meditation, only chanting, like that, pure karma, pure life, okay?